Hello friends, in previous lecture we see shortest path problem and shortest path problem we see Descartes algorithm. Now in this lecture we are going to study cut vertices and connectivity. Definition of cut vertices, see here. A vertex we have G is called cut vertex of G if W of G minus V greater than W of G. That means number of connecting component of G minus V is greater than number of connected component of G. A vertex V of a graph G is called cut vertex. Of G if W of G minus V greater than W of G. That means a vertex V is a cut vertex of G if its deletion disconnects some connected components of G. That means if we delete G and edges incident to, sorry, if we delete V and edges incident to V, we get disconnected graph. Connected graph becomes disconnected graph. Then V is called cut vertex. See here, for example, here in this graph G1, here V is cut vertex. If we delete V from G1, then we get three components, connected components, this one, only isolated vertex and this. Here in G2, no cut vertex. If we delete this vertex, then we get connected graph. Any vertex, if we delete, then we get, that means in G2, there is no cut vertex. There is no cut vertex. One theorem here, let G be a vertex of the connected graph G, let GV, sorry, V be a vertex of connected graph G, then V is cut vertex of G, is cut vertex of G if and only if there are two vertices, there are two vertices U and W of G both different from U, both different from, sorry, V, such that V is on every UV path. Every UV path in G. If V is a cut vertex of G, if and only there are two vertices U and W and both different from V, so that V is on every UV path. So that UV on every path. See here, let v be a cut vertex, let v be a cut vertex of g, then g minus v is disconnected, that means g minus v more connected component than g, so there are two vertices u and w in g which will lie different component, that means u lie in one component connected component and w lie another connected component, of g minus v. There is path. U W path in G. Since G is connected, so for any two vertices, there is a path. U W path in G. And there is no path U W in G minus V. In G minus V is disconnected graph and U belongs to one component, W belongs to another. So there is no path in G minus V. That means this implies, that every path in G, from U to W contains vertex V. Conversely, suppose U and W are two different vertices in G. U and W and different from V. That means U is not equal to V and W is not equal to V. Every path in G from U to W contains vertex V. Every path from U to W in G contains vertex V, then there can be no path. From UV path, UW path in G minus V. Because V contain in every path of UW. If we delete V, then there is no path. And so, G minus V is disconnected and therefore V is a cut vertex. Now again one more theorem. Let G be a graph with n vertices. And n is greater than or equal to 2. Where n is greater than or equal to 2. Then G has at least two vertices. Which are not cut vertex. which are not cut vertices. See here, one more definition. Here, D of UV, G is a connected graph, U and V are two vertices, both are different. D of UV means distance between U and V is the shortest length, shortest path. D of U is the length of shortest path. Path from U to V distance. Now, one more definition, eccentricity. Eccentricity. It is denoted by E of V, and E of V is equal to maximum U of V, distance U of V, for U belongs to V and U is not equal to V. Eccentricity of V means maximum distance from V to any other vertex to V. Now, radius of G is equal to minimum EV. Minimum EV, and V belongs to this capital V, the vertex set of G, and diameter is maximum eccentricity. Diameter of G is equal to maximum eccentricity. V belongs to capital V. Now see, for this theorem we use here diameter. For this theorem we use here diameter. Now we assuming that there is at most one vertex. There is at most one vertex in G which is not a cut vertex, which is not a cut vertex. Okay, now U and V in G, vertices in G, so that distance between U and V is the greatest distance, is the greatest distance. So D of UV is equal to diameter of G. Diameter of G. Since G is connected, and at least two vertices connected and has at least two vertices. U and U and V not equal. Thus, by our assumption, we see here in G there is at most one vertex in G which is not a cut vertex. So here at most one vertex in G which is not a cut vertex, that means another vertex may be cut vertex. Okay, by assumption. Okay, one of these vertex from these two, one of these vertex is cut vertex, say V, cut vertex, say V. Then G minus V is disconnected. So there is a vertex W. So there is a vertex W in G, which does not belong to, which does not belongs to the same component. Same component as you does in G. That means W belongs to another component and U belongs to another component. U and W belongs to different component. Different component as in G minus V. That means every UV UW path in G, that means every UW path, UW path in G contains a vertex V, contains a vertex V. Therefore, see here, D of UW is equal to D of UV plus D of VW. This implies D of UW greater than D of UV, greater than UV, and which is contradiction because D of U is the diameter, is the greatest distance between two vertices in G. Here we get here D of UV greater than, which is a contradiction. So our assumption is wrong. That means there is at most one vertex in G which is wrong. So our result is required. That means at least G is a graph with n vertices, then G has at least two vertices which are not cut vertex, which is not cut vertex. Now here, next definition, give a simple graph the connectivity of G, vertex connectivity of G denoted by K of G is the smallest number of vertices in G, is the smallest in G denoted by, sorry, in G whose deleting, whose deletion from G leaves either a disconnected graph or K1, either disconnected graph or K1. K1 means isolated, either disconnected graph or only isolated vertex. Here in this example, see here, if we delete this vertex we get disconnected graph. So here KG1 is equal to 1. Here no cut vertex. If we delete these two, then we get two components. So here KG2 is equal to 2. Now one more example here. G3. Here G3, if we delete any two, then this is connected. But if we delete these three vector, three vertices, then we get disconnected, then KG3 is equal to 3, like this. If you another example take like this, now this is, if we delete any two, then we get connected graph. Suppose we delete this three, but this also get connected. If you delete 1, 2, 3 and 4, suppose if we delete 4 vertices, then we get disconnected. And sorry, this is G4, KG4 is equal to 4. That means if we delete 4 vertices, then we get disconnected graph. Now, a simple graph G definition. A simple graph. Graph G is called unconnected if K of G greater than or equal to N. If K of G greater than or equal to, here this G4 is 4 connected, here G3 is 3 connected, this is 2 connected, also 2 connected, also 1 connected, okay. Here G is equal to KN. If you delete any vertex from KN, we get the result. We get the result KN minus 1. If we deleting, that means KN minus V, any vertex, we get KN minus 1, complete graph on N vertices. If we delete, T is set of vertices, or set of vertices, that means subset of vertices. T is a subset of V. V is a set of vertices in G, or and G is a KN. Then K of delete KN minus टी दिस गिव्स के एन माइनस टी के एन एंड के ऑफ के एन इज इक्वल टू एन माइनस वन के ऑफ के एन कंप्लीट ग्राफ ऑफ एन वर्टाइसेस दैट मीन नंबर ऑफ वर्टाइसेस deleting number of vertices we get disconnected graph this is n minus 1 here we get delete n minus 1 vertices from kn then we get only isolated vertex then we get only isolated vertex so we stop here.